Hi there, my name is Allan Knight, and I'd like to welcome you warmly to this free seminar on social anxiety, actually conquering social anxiety. I've been a coach and trainer for, I think it's over 25 years now, and it amazes me how rampant, how pervasive insecurity, loneliness, social anxiety has become in our world. It's amazing because with the advent of social media, one would think that we're more connected than ever before. But in fact, I think the millennials have a greater suicide rate than ever before. So it is an issue. It is a problem. And that is the reason for this free webinar. And it's brief 25 minutes. I'm hoping to share with you some ideas, some thoughts, some insights, perhaps a strategy or two. And most importantly, the strategy of how you can transform these fears and insecurities into confidence, boldness, and personal magnetism in a relatively short period of time. So without further ado, I am going to share my screen with you, and I will ask you for your patience as I do. There we go. Slideshow from beginning. I think we're okay now. So, as I said before, my name is Allan Knight, and I welcome you to this free webinar, which should be about 25 minutes, maximum 30 minutes. And my first question to you is the following. Would you agree that communication skills are among the most important assets that we could possibly have in order to succeed in today's world, both in our business and in our personal relationships? Every day, the reality is we need to connect with people, our family, friends, cohorts, colleagues, sales team, if we're a sales manager, entrepreneur, we got to connect with people, network. Communication skills are very, very critical. So we need to delve a bit into what's holding us back from mastering the art of our communication. That's the key of this webinar. So let's start by asking you why you're here. Can you relate to any of the following scenarios? Number one, do you literally freeze at the thought of speaking in front of a group? I do meetup groups all the time, and I'm always amazed at people who have even high levels of education. You ask them to come up for 30 seconds or 60 seconds to do an elevator speech, and they really react to it. They freeze. And so you know what that feels like. It doesn't feel very good, and certainly impacts your self-confidence and self-esteem. Are you somebody that's overly preoccupied with what others think? If you are, then you're not living your true life with your true vision, true purpose, with 100% intentionality, because you're still too worried about what others think, and that dictates some of your actions, and it will certainly affect some of your communication. So are you one of these people that way too often thinks about what others think of you and are too worried about it? Are you sick and tired of attracting codependent dysfunctional relationships? I mean, many of us in our lives go a whole life without ever knowing true love. And when I talk about true love, I mean someone you feel really connected to. There's an amazingly strong connection. Call it soulmate, call it whatever you want. But it's a heart-centered communication that's founded on emotional intimacy, trust, fun, loving spirit, passion, and the list goes on. And yet most of us are locked in to very dysfunctional relationships. So the question is, are you tired of that? Do you feel sometimes socially awkward when you're at a party or a networking event? And sometimes some of the most basic conversational skills are difficult. Are you really pissed off when you see others have what you don't have? And often we get into comparing ourselves. How could that guy have that girl? So do you get pissed off when you actually start comparing yourself and feel in some way like life is passing you by? Do you feel intimidated when you're with somebody you're in awe of, someone with a strong personality or someone you're highly attracted to? The other day, a gentleman said to me, he says, if I meet a woman that I'm not really attracted to, I have no problem. But as soon as I meet someone I'm really attracted to, oh, freeze, the pit of the stomach. Very, very not fun kind of experience. So as I said before, do you feel like in some ways like life is simply passing you by? If you could relate to some or all of these points, you're absolutely at the right place because that's what we're going to talk about today. If none of these are connected to you, we're happy that you came here, but this, you're wasting your time. This is not for you. So another thing that a lot of people notice is that they might have attended, they might have done a lot of life coaching. They've read a lot of self-help books or gone to rah-rah seminars. And even those have not been enough. So you're here partially because you might be thinking, is there another way? Because I've invested a lot of money. I've already invested a lot of time and it's simply not working. Again, you're at the right place. So let me take you through a little bit of a map here to show you how this works. On the top, this little area I call dream lifestyle. If I sat down with each and every one of you and we had a coffee for 15 minutes and I asked you the right questions, you'd probably in a short order be able to describe your dream desired lifestyle. We all would. I mean, at the end of the day, what do we want? We want inner peace. We want love. We want to have amazing relationships. We want to have success in our career, financial freedom, fun, great friends, great hobbies, etc. We all pretty well want the same thing or a variation of that. The reality, in order to speed along to achieve our dream lifestyle, it starts at the bottom with what I call the Zen zone. Call it the Zen zone, spirit, your higher self, really needs to run the show. The problem is that the Zen zone is connected to our emotions, our rational analytical mind, and our physical body. And what happens there, these four cylinders that you see in blue, if they're working really effectively and efficiently, will guide us and propel us to living that dream lifestyle. It'll propel us to effectively communicate with others in a highly effective, efficient way. However, the problem lies in that often the emotional, psychological crap from the past imbues our life. And so instead of on an emotional level being content, full of love and happiness, we have anger, we have fear, we have anxiety, we have frustration, we have sadness, depression. On the mind level, we're either too hyperactive in our thinking or negative thinking, and the physical body either goes to one extreme of procrastination or obsession on the other side. So if that happens, that clouds the Zen zone. We're not tapped into the calm, clear mind. We're not accessing intuition, and we have all the psychological and emotional cloudiness, so to speak, impacting every area of our life, and we're not streaming and rippling ahead toward living our dream lifestyle. So in a nutshell, the 9-step formula that I created connects all these dots in a very unique way so that within 60 to 90 days, you actually get to quite a high level of living in that calm, clear Zen zone and a very healthy sense of emotional, psychological feeling, physical actions, which are balanced and prioritized and ultimately oozes out into our day-to-day communication, thereby achieving our dream lifestyle. So I thought I would share that little map to show you how the connecting links share together. So I want to welcome you to a fresh, unique, and practical approach that I've developed over the last 25 years to literally help you fast track your ability to communicate both in business and in your personal life with a high degree of clarity, confidence, and impact. And a little later, I'm going to share more how that works. But first, I want to share a little bit about myself because I want to make it clear that I'm sharing all these things with you today, not based on ideas that I've developed, but from personal life experience. I can relate to your pain. As a matter of fact, I can relate in such a way that my early years were characterized by extreme fears and insecurities. I happened to be living in the shadow of an older brother, Larry, a wonderful guy, who was king of his high school, number one in the medical class, very good-looking guy, one of the best athletes in the school. And I was a good athlete, but very insecure and always felt compared to my brother. That guy on the right is me at the age of 21. And when my brother sent me that photograph about 3-4 years ago, I said, hey, that's a good looking guy. And then I realized how much I hated myself when I was that 21-year-old. Legs were too skinny. I hated how I looked. I had difficulty approaching women that I was strongly attracted to. I felt like a loser. And all I could do was play baseball pretty well. I was a pitcher. By the way, that's not me. That's Sandy Koufax of the Los Angeles Dodgers. But some people thought that I was a professional baseball player. So I don't want to mislead you on that one. So I could relate to your pain because there's nothing like suffering. Sometimes emotional pain is more substantial and more painful than even physical pain. So I lived for many, many years with feelings of insecurity, timidity, and just overall feeling like I was never going to get ahead in life and never really going to attract what I really wanted to attract into my life. So my life really changed dramatically at the age of 21 when I took a year off from my bachelor in psychology and I went and traveled around the world and came very, very close to dying on the desert. It was actually a heat stroke one day when I walked about 25 miles to the Mediterranean Sea. It was about 125 degrees and I had a piece of bread and a piece of tomato. And as I walked back alone on the desert, my heart started beating, palpitating, and I fell under a tree. It was the only tree on the desert. And then miraculously, some people found me. And the next thing I know, I was on the balcony of some couple and told me that many soldiers die of what's called a heat stroke. And I had a heat stroke. So that was a very significant life-changing experience in my life, which then motivated me to go inward to seek out spirituality. Because up until then, I was pretty atheistic. And I started to get onto my personal development journey, which really changed my life forever. I then went on to obtain my master's degree in education from McGill University in Montreal. And my thesis at that time was all about the quality of relationships with others are founded on the quality of the relationship that we have with ourselves. And that's been my modus operandi ever since. And I got really excited about the idea of not just becoming a life coach, but I wanted to create a system that would truly help people transform more quickly. Because as I began to develop myself, I started to realize that knowledge is not power. We hear this expression, knowledge is power. And knowledge is power if we want to be a doctor and learn a lot of facts and knowledge. That's important. If we want to become a social scientist, knowledge is power. But when it comes to interpersonal skills in our relationships, I found in many cases the opposite is true. The heart is power. There's a limitation to awareness alone. We read books, we go to rah-rah seminars, we have life coaching. It's all great, but we're getting more and more aware. But what I found is unless you take that awareness into action and ultimately take that action into effective communication, the awareness alone is not enough. And that's why I knew that I wanted to go on and develop a practical system that was also a self-coaching system for life. So if anyone got off track, they could pick themselves up by the bootstraps, get back on track, and have what I call true transformation. So question is, how are you doing? How would you rate yourself after years of perhaps pursuing personal development yourself, having gone to therapy or access life coaching, or after reading the books and attending the rah-rah seminars? And by the way, this is not a criticism of any of it. I've done a lot of it, benefited by all of it. I'm just talking about perhaps there's some things that you can do to speed up the process that wasn't always possible with these methods of growth. Are you still suffering from ADD, lack of focus, low self-confidence, lack of clarity, or simply poor or ineffective communication skills? So let's take a closer look. Now, what I'd like you to do, and maybe you could do it, if you click on that link below, you can complete this exercise later so you have a better idea of how you rate. But one of the things that's very valuable is to just take stock of yourself. And a really good exercise is to rate yourself 0 to 100%, 0 low, 100% high, or anywhere between. It could be 20%, 30%, 40%. How you feel about yourself in the following categories, and if you want, you can even add more categories. Physical health, inner peace, time management. Most of the ones on the left are related to the relationship you have with yourself. The ones on the right, for the most part, are related to your communication. So when you fill this out completely, then maybe circle the lowest six. And you'll really notice as you circle the lower six and realize the lowest six scores that you have are often rooted in the lack of inner power that you have. Because communication and achieving your desired lifestyle all starts, 80% of it oozes out from the inside out. So how do you feel if the score stayed exactly the same? If I met you in a year and your scores are relatively mediocre, how would you feel in a year if they pretty well stayed the same? You probably feel a little disappointed in yourself. On the other hand, if I had a magic wand and touched you on the forehead and automatically, miraculously, every one of those categories are 90% plus, you'd be ecstatic, you'd be happy, you'd feel relief, you'd feel buoyed, you'd feel joyful, you'd feel alive, and your life would never be the same. You'd live life at a very, very high level. So it's time to ask yourself, are you sufficiently fed up with mediocrity? Many people I meet know that there are a lot of things they need to work on to grow, but they're not always emotionally fed up. And what I found out over the years is nothing is going to happen unless you get fed up, unless it gets to the emotional level, not just the awareness level. You need to get to the place where you say, the gig is up. I am ready to do whatever it takes to make it happen. Along my personal development journey, I took a lot of programs, and one of them I sold a car for, I think it was $3,000-$4,000, because I attended this presentation and I said, I need to do this. And my mind said, I can't do it, I can't afford it. And then I said, hold it, I need to do it. I'm gonna find a way, come hell or high water. And then I realized I had an old clunky car that I didn't want anyway, sold it, took that course, and that course was one of the most important courses I took along my personal transformation. So the question is, are you sufficiently fed up with mediocrity? Are you sick and tired of having unfulfilling relationships? Are you disappointed at your lack of success? And are you truly ready to do something different? So the question is, can you do it alone, or do you need the tools, techniques, and support from an outside sort, be it Allan Knight or someone else, to make it happen? And most people I ask that question to would say, well, if I was able to do it alone, I would have done it by now. So if you feel you need some support, you're at the right place. So how would you like to dramatically become a master communicator, and in so doing, you finally achieve the success, happiness, and the love you've always dreamed of? And if you think that's not possible in a short order, you're wrong. That is why I spent 25 years in the laboratory to create the 9-step formula, which is a very unique program. And I'll tell you some of the features that it has that are very powerful. Number one, it's highly practical and results oriented. It's not just about information. It's not just about awareness. It's about tools and techniques that get you there. And it's also comprehensive because it connects the mind to your emotion, to your action, to your intuition, to your communication. It has all the bases covered. It's a complete and duplicatable system that's very powerful. You actually get results within 90 days. When I say 90 days, some of my clients get get results a lot faster. But to go through it comprehensively, to be safe, I say 90 days or sooner. So it's a very fast-track system. We also have some maintenance and follow-up, which are very powerful. So as you get off track, you're able to pick yourself up by the bootstraps and stay on track more and more and more. And as you get into what I call that Zen zone of self-mastery, life becomes very, very magical. And then finally, you become your own life coach for life. It's great. If you want to take more seminars and read books, be my guest. Go ahead. But I think a lot of times we're kind of clinging on and jumping from this one, jumping to another seminar, reading another book, taking bits and pieces. But sometimes we just want to put a lot of those pieces together in a one-stop shop that has it all. So this is some of the benefits of the 9 steps. And what are the benefits for you? Number one, you're going to master your conversational skills, which again is crucial in your personal and business relationships. You're going to learn to overcome social anxiety forever. I lived like that for a long time, and I am so blessed and great and appreciative of the fact that I live in general inner freedom, happiness, contentment. There's very little social anxiety here, and it's amazing to be living like this. You're going to become more bold and highly confident so that you'll be able to approach anybody at any time and not feel so intimidated. You'll be able to attract amazing relationships, be more authentic and assertive when you need to be. and experience deep levels of inner peace, which is so important as we navigate this very busy lifestyle of us at this time. And overall, you'll be able to empower all of your networking, speaking, and closing skills if it comes to business. So, question. If you are really serious about getting clear on what you want out of life, if you're highly serious about letting go of the things that are still holding you back, you're fed up, if you're committed to growing and taking personal development to a whole new level, if you're serious about taking focused and consistent action in your life, because a lot of us read books and go to seminars, but we don't take the action. You got to follow up with action. And are you serious about succeeding in your career and, of course, attracting like-minded people into your life? Schedule a call with Mr. Allan Knight. That would be me. 45-minute complimentary evaluation and assessment to provide you the feedback and the strategies for success. Now, in this call, I will help you get super, super clear on who you are, where you are, what's holding you back, why those things are holding you back, and most importantly, I'll go over the 9-step formula to show you the strategy of how you can turn that around in very short order. The session is geared for individuals who are highly serious about taking their life to the next level. Obviously, we prefer people that are ready to be coached, are interested in coaching. We're just doing it to see if there's a fit. You'll certainly, at the very least, gain clarity, be more motivated, and discover again if the one-to-one coaching with myself is your solution. So schedule a call now, and I just hope you enjoy this little seminar. I hope it gave you some insights as to what social anxiety is all about, where some of it comes from, and how you turn it around. So I would like to wish each one of you all the best of success, and I'd like to invite you to schedule a call. At the very least, go to allanknight.com and access the 9 steps, even if you don't take coaching with myself, and at least access the 9 steps so you get a better idea of how these 9 steps could dramatically change your life. In the meantime, all the best of success, and we'll talk to you all soon.